Ever pondered why God didn't equip us with a cosmic preview button, revealing life's climax right from the start? Would you trade the mystery of faith for a predictable script where complaining loses its audience? Could trust in God survive in a world where foresight reigns supreme? Now reflect. Is it possible that your inability to foresee the future is divinely orchestrated? A challenge, perhaps, to trust God in the absence of a crystal ball, to believe that beyond the present unknown, He holds something better for you. Can you muster that level of trust? Can your faith move God to unveil His master plan? Before we continue, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't. Let's simplify it. What if the essence of faith is trusting God, even in the fog of uncertainty? Imagine preparing a meal for your 5-year-old. She's clueless about the culinary symphony, but does she fuss? No. Why? Because she trusts that whatever you're cooking will translate into a delectable feast. Can you approach God with such childlike confidence, certain that whatever He's orchestrating will be for your ultimate delight? Shift focus. Does faith star in your daily interactions with God? Remember, the Bible declares that without faith, pleasing God is off the table. Reflect on moments when your faith deficit blocked divine pleasures. Have you forfeited special deliveries from God, not because they were absent, but because you failed to spot them or lacked the patience to wait? Now, contemplate. When God nudges you to release your grip, is it His way of making room for something superior? Can you relinquish the present, trusting that God is preparing an upgrade? Picture those moments of hesitation, of holding on to the now, while God is plotting a grander next. Can you break free, stepping into the unknown? Beloved, when God whispers, "Let go of what you have," is it an invitation to embrace His something better? Do you find it hard to release, fearing that God's better might be a mirage? Consider the instances you clung to the familiar, possibly forfeiting God's bespoke blessings. Are you prepared to unravel the unknown, confident that God's hidden masterpiece awaits you? The challenge resounds. To trust, to let go, and to embrace the unseen, unveiling a divine tapestry crafted just for you. Regrettably, when faced with the choice to release the old for the promise of something superior, many cling desperately to the familiar. They plead, "But God, I cherish this one." Undeniably, the attachment is strong, yet God yearns to hand you the superior, and if you clasp the present too tightly, His gift remains unoffered. Hebrews 11:40 whispers, "God had something better in mind for us," a resounding call to relinquish the lesser for the greater. Recall the man at the beautiful gate, eyes set on silver and gold from Peter and John. His expectations soared, yet God had a grander plan. Beyond material wealth, God sought to grant him restored health, an enduring treasure. Unbeknownst to him, that divine encounter held a value far beyond the glimmer of gold. Do you grasp the depth of what God might have in store if you release your grip on the temporal? Reflect on the tale of the 10 lepers, each cleansed by Jesus. Healing, yes, but God intended more. Sadly, only one sees the richer reward, a testament to the impact of attitude. Impatience aside, the wrong demeanor can rob you of God's design. What attitudes hinder blessings? Ingratitude, pride, fear, and murmuring stand as formidable barriers. Could your attitude be the key to unlocking God's unparalleled blessings? Consider, if you hold on to what you possess, could you be forfeiting the divine upgrade God yearns to bestow? Are you ready to loosen your grip, trusting that God's something better awaits, veiled behind the curtain of faith? It's a daring journey into the unknown, where God beckons with promises of superior treasures for those willing to let go. Consider the tale of Jeremiah, the reluctant prophet chosen by God. Recall how fear gripped him, feeling unqualified, facing rejection, enduring pain. Yet he clung to trust, refusing to be swayed by the storms around him. Despite the hardships, he remained anchored in God's purpose. What if he succumbed to fear, letting it eclipse his trust? The unfolding of God's grand plan for him would have remained veiled. His steadfast trust revealed God's unwavering commitment to his well-being. Picture a Jeremiah paralyzed by fear, drowning in self-doubt. The riches of God's plan would have stayed concealed. It's a powerful reminder that trust unveils the intricate tapestry of God's intentions. Stay attuned to the divine frequencies, committed to the spiritual realm. Understand that a delay in answers doesn't equate to God's abandonment. It's not a sign of divine indifference. Isaiah 59:1 echoes, "Surely the arm of the Lord is not too short to save, nor his ear too dull to hear." Dig deeper, and you'll find that sin can create a chasm between you and God. Yet, even in righteousness, prayer answers may tarry. Why? Not because God's ear is deaf to your pleas, but because he orchestrates something grand, cooking up the finest blessings in the divine kitchen. The delay is not neglect. It's meticulous preparation for the perfect moment of manifestation. Enter the narrative of Hannah, a woman enduring the sting of barrenness, despite years of marriage. The relentless mockery labeling her as barren echoed, yet she clung to prayer, never allowing impatience to claim her. Samuel, the answer to her fervent prayers, arrived after a protracted period of waiting. Why did God linger, not responding to her pleas in the initial cries for a child? The unveiling truth lies in the divine orchestration. Samuel needed to emerge precisely when he did, destined to become a prophet. Contemplate this. Had Samuel arrived in the early chapters of Hannah's marital tale, perhaps her devotion to dedicating him to God's service wouldn't have been as profound. Can you fathom the intricate workings of God's timing? In the pauses of answered prayers, God fashions your character. He sculpts virtues that align with his purpose, ensuring that when blessings come, they serve his glory. Reflect on your fervent prayers. For financial breakthroughs, career advancements, or life companionship. Amidst the waiting, resist surrender. The delay, though seemingly prolonged, is a facet of divine wisdom. God intentionally holds back prosperity, scrutinizing your spiritual landscape. He gauges whether the receipt of wealth and success might inadvertently replace him at the core of your existence, weighing your priorities against material allure. Consider the plight of the affluent, absorbed in their businesses and novel money-making tactics. They've forsaken God, ensnared in the allure of wealth. Making money is commendable. God yearns for your prosperity. However, amidst affluence, cultivate a profound relationship with God. Let not the opulence divert your gaze from the divine. When confronted with deferred responses and unrealized hopes, resist the urge to grumble or cease praying. Persist in trusting God. He transcends human fallibility. His promises are irrevocable. If he declares his plans for you are brimming with hope and a promising future, anticipate his response, surpassing your expectations. Patience is your ally. Remember, God leverages disappointments and refusals to seize your attention, preparing the stage for something superior. Have you ever yearned for something fervently, only to watch it slip away? The emotions are familiar, sadness and disappointment. Yet, God orchestrates these losses to unveil himself in a different light. Beloved, if you fixated on human pathways for too long, recognize that God is the sole conduit to all your aspirations. Disappointment may be inherent in human experiences, but failing to grasp this truth may propel you into the wall of divine redirection. Consider the story of Ruth, who, in her youth, faced the tragedy of losing her husband. When her mother-in-law decided to return to Jerusalem, Ruth, unswayed by uncertainty, resolved to follow. Unfamiliar with Jerusalem, she leaned on the God of her mother-in-law, relinquishing her reliance on human reasoning. Ruth's faith-backed decision, though seemingly uncertain, led to God orchestrating a divine setup, making her one of Christ's ancestors. A life fully yielded to God's plan, regardless of personal understanding, can be transformed beyond imagination. God's plans for you surpass any self-fashioned schemes. Even in the darkest moments, trust Him. Ruth's resilience in the face of her husband's death, a circumstance that often shatters faith, sets an example. Instead of succumbing, she drew closer to God, aligning her life with his intended path. Will you permit your life to follow God's plan? Can you overcome panic, entrusting yourself to God's unfailing hand? Recall the comforting words of Jesus in Matthew 28:20, assuring his disciples of perpetual companionship until the end of the age. He dispatched the Comforter to maintain their connection with him. Reflect on how, while hanging on the cross, Jesus entrusted the care of his earthly mother to a disciple he trusted. Just as Jesus cared for Mary, he's equally attentive to your needs. Will you lean into his enduring presence? Know this, God's love for you surpasses any love you might receive from humanity. Even in the face of adversity and suffering, God is tirelessly working to bring about the best for you. Don't surrender to the pressures from any side. Don't relinquish your trust in God. The hardships you encounter serve a purpose, a divine design outlined by the Apostle Paul in Romans 5:3-4. He asserts that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance builds character, and character instills hope. In the crucible of difficult times, your patience and trust in God are tested. Paul's words are not mere rhetoric, but born out of personal experience. His life, marked by suffering for the gospel, stands as a testament to the transformative power of enduring faith. His encouragement echoes through the corridors of time to uplift every child of God. Reflect on Job's story, a saga of unimaginable loss and suffering. Yet because Job loved and trusted God, the tragedy was not the end. Something better emerged from the depths of his adversity. Knowing this, introspect. How can I uncover, identify, and relish the best of what God has in store for me? Start by seeking him daily, aligning with Matthew 6:32-34, which implores you not to fret about worldly concerns, but to prioritize God's kingdom and righteousness. This, the passage assures, will prompt God to provide abundantly. In your journey, remember, God's awareness spans the depth of your suffering. Allow your trials to refine you, just as gold is purified by fire. Persevere, for through adversity, God molds you into a reflection of Christ. The question lingers, will you trust God's process, believing that beyond the suffering, he is crafting something extraordinary for you? Embrace the truth. Each day carries its own challenges, but your heavenly Father holds the solutions to all your needs. Today, take heart, for when you seek God, the things promised by men and unfulfilled will be effortlessly given and even surpassed. Draw near to him through the constant study of his word, where the richness of his nature unfolds. Move to the next step. Ask God to unveil his purpose for your life. In your pursuit of dreams, disappointment looms when they exist outside his will. Discover your unique talents and passions. Align them with God's purpose. Your plans are valid, but discerning your true purpose leads to boundless joy and fulfillment. Now, the challenge. Practice patience and trust in God's timing. A task easier said than done. When detours and setbacks emerge, focus on God alone. The life of Joseph, marked by betrayal, slavery, and imprisonment, echoes the essence of enduring hope. Rejecting Potiphar's wife's outer, Joseph clung to God's plan, leading him from suffering to a position of power and reconciliation. Jeremiah 29:11 assures you of a future filled with hope. In this journey, consider the implications of these steps. As you seek, ask, and patiently trust, you align yourself with God's divine rhythm, unlocking a path where your needs are met, your purpose fulfilled, and hope for the future sustained. Will you embark on this transformative journey, allowing God's promises to shape your story? In moments of pain and hardship, it's easy to doubt if God truly cares. Consider Jesus on the cross, the agony he bore, crying, "My God, why hast thou forsaken me?" In life's trials, we feel the same abandonment. Yet, God didn't forsake Jesus. He looked beyond the present to future glory, averting his gaze out of love. You might be in a similar moment, feeling forsaken. God isn't absent. He's focused on the bigger picture, the future, the glory ahead. He whispers, "Just a little more endurance, patience, and your harvest awaits." Now, the challenge is humility. Look at how it exalted Jesus. In the same way, humble yourself before God. Let pride never sway you from enjoying the best He has for you. Remember, humility not only lifts but keeps you in an exalted position. So, embrace humility on this journey, acknowledging that it's the key to unlocking the greatness God has in store for you. Will you stay humble and endure for the promise of a glorious future? Let us pray. Heavenly Father, the sustainer of my life, I bask in gratitude for your immeasurable goodness. Thank you for unseen battles fought on my behalf, thwarting the devil's plans. My praise for your enduring mercy knows no bounds. I kneel before your throne, pleading for a new heart, one molded to love and follow your will. Grant me grace to embrace your plans and insight to discern them. If I stray from your path, gently redirect me. My earthly purpose is to serve you. Remove anything hindering that. Bless the works of my hands, Father. Let prosperity and health accompany my journey, aligning with your desire for my well-being. I declare prosperity but reject pursuits that jeopardize my soul and joy. I resist the enemy's bait, choosing the enduring wealth of your blessings. May my steps align with your purpose, dear Father, for in your mercy, I find my strength and purpose. Lord, unveil the better things you have for me. Grant strength to release what I clench tightly. Cultivate in me a heart of enduring patience as I await your timing. Empower me not to waver in my trust while I linger in anticipation. Purify my heart, shaping my character in your likeness. Eradicate impatience, pride, and fear. Grant me the grace to embody humility and surrender. Heal the fractures in my life and restore all that has been lost. Provide unwavering strength to persevere through adversity. My life is a testament to your faithfulness, and I trust you to guide me through the path of righteousness. Amen. If this prayer resonates with you, share this video with your loved ones. Help us reach more souls and spread the gospel. Your support is cherished. Thank you. See you in the next video.